Hello and welcome. We are in New York for Swift Business Forum, and I'm now joined by Pat Antonacci, who is the head of Swift Customer Security Program. Pat, thank you for joining me. Tell me about the program. It was set up a year ago. What has happened during this year?
Yeah, so we launched the program in May of last year, and it really drives around three core mutually supporting pillars. One is around securing and protecting your own environment. So ensuring that each organization is taking the actions to both secure against best practices, security controls, and attesting that security best practice to each of their counterparties. They permission their counterparties to see that information, as well as securing the infrastructure and the systems behind that infrastructure. So that's securing and protecting their own environment. The second piece of the pillar is around ensuring that they can detect if there has been a compromise, and preventing that compromise. So the prevention and detection, we offer also now offer commercial opportunities. We leverage something called a daily validation report, which out of band then it can identify if transactions have occurred. If you thought you did 1,500 transactions and the daily validation report is gonna show you that you did 1,503, you know there was a potential compromise. We're also now launching a payments control effort that allows you to put at the network level some of the same controls that you would put locally, like the highest value of a transaction, the hours that you execute transactions, et cetera. So that's around making sure that you are preventing and detecting if something has occurred. And then the last piece of the process is information sharing. So a forum like this gives us a great opportunity to push that information sharing, ensuring that the community as a whole, if they are compromised or there's an attempt to that compromise, they share that information with us. We anonymize that information and share it with the greater community to ensure that people are preventing things and happening, and they're educated on what is the potential compromise. So from information sharing is key, and events like this give us a further opportunity to engage with the community.
What has been the take up from the industry?
So I think it's a great take up. It's a little over a year in motion now. We're now running roadshows and workshops with the community. We're in over 200 countries and territories. So we have over 170 of those on the ground in local language, working with the community to make sure that they understand what is the need that they need, the action they need to take, and what's the action that their counterparties need to take so that they can start in the attestation process, which starts in July. One, they can attest that they're meeting the best practices, but also how they're gonna start consuming that information and making risk-based decisions on who they're going to continue to do business with from a counterparty perspective.
So prevention is always important. Is it something that the industry is also warming up to, the idea that they need to really focus on this?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the threats continue to evolve. The bad guys are organized and they're doing information sharing one another. They're trading ideas, so we as a community need to come together to do the same thing, right? Cyber and preventing these things is not a competitive advantage. It's something that the community is starting to share more and more to make sure that as a greater community, we can be as strong or stronger than the bad guys who are doing things. But that's just the prevention piece, right? Identifying when things happen and having a plan and a response plan on how to address when those things happen. A lot of CISOs you'll talk to will say, you know, if you haven't been compromised, it's just yet, or to the extent that you understand. So it's making sure that you're ever vigilant to protect yourself, but also know how to respond if something does happen to you or one of your counterparties and you're being impacted by something that happens to one of your counterparties.
Okay, so but thank you. You joined the session earlier on today. I think you have two more to go. It will be good to catch up with you at the end of the event off camera and hear your views on how it all went.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your